Now we are going to look at the results from our forced pipe convection. To do this, we need to first open up CFD post. So double click on results. The first thing that we're going to look at is the temperature and the contours of temperature throughout the pipe. So let's click on the z-axis and we're going to add a contour of temperature. So click on the contours button and we'll call this temperature contour. We will set the location of our temperature contour to be on periodic 1. And the variable will be temperature. And we'll set the number of contours to be 101. So now we can click apply. Well, we can't really see much, so in order to make it more visible, what we're going to do is we're going to stretch the contour by a factor of 30. To do this, click in the View tab and go down to Apply Scale. We'll stretch it by a factor of 30 in the Y direction. Click Apply. Okay, so now we can kind of see what's going on here. To make it look even better, we're going to reflect it so that we can see the entire pipe. To do this, double-click on Default Transform, uncheck Instancing Info, and go down to Apply Reflection. The method will be from the ZX plane. Click Apply. Great, now we have our full pipe. We can see here, this is where the heating is. And now we can see at the very end of the heating, where we're mixing everything, how it looks to be just about uniform. This means that our assumption for measuring the mixed mean temperature there with one measurement is valid.